Hey there, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the HTTP 415 error in WordPress. While using images, video, and GIFs was not typical in the early days of the web, we now expect that a site offers appealing visuals as well as informative text. It's also no surprise that when the communication between the browser and server goes awry due to a mismatch in media, you'll see an error. In this case, the HTTP 415 error. So in this video, we're going to look into the HTTP 415 error and talk about what causes it. From there, we'll discuss how you fix it. But before we move along too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what is this 415 error? HTTP 415 error is one of many 400 status codes. If you understand that it buddies up with errors such as 404, you'll begin to understand what's happening. In short, 400 errors all deal with something missing that either the client or the server needs. The full name of the error is a 415 unsupported media type. The server is receiving a media file that it doesn't recognize or can't accept. Regardless of what you call it, it means that the server refuses to accept a request from the browser. This will often be because whatever the browser sends, it isn't in the right format. For example, a general error-catching strategy will stop a user from taking an unrecognized file type and uploading it through an interface that only accepts PNGs. However, if you don't specify the exact types of media a server can process, it would trigger an error on the back end. On the front end, a user might not see anything at all. WordPress users get an admin screen notification like this. The good news is that WordPress has a permissive infrastructure. Think of the different file types you could upload to the media library, for example. Even so, this is a developer-level issue rather than a user issue. To recap, the HTTP 415 error tells you that the server won't accept a file type because it doesn't support the payload. This means there's an issue with the underlying PHP code that needs a fix. At this point, if you aren't the developer of the site or theme and you don't have any coding skills, you'll likely want to contact someone with expertise. Poking around in your theme's files could cause an issue. However, the Mozilla documentation on the error gives you two clues to begin your search. Two representation headers called content type and content encoding. The content type header provides the client request with the resource before any encoding happens. It indicates the original media type of the resource. For example, in contrast, content encoding is a list of all the encodings the payload, or your media, has, which is an indicator of how the file should be decoded in order to get the original payload, as you can see here. As you can tell, file compression is a common way to encode data. This isn't a problem in theory, but will be if you don't code this into the relevant files for your theme or plugin. You have three avenues to explore if you uncover an HTTP 415 error. All of them are relating to your PHP code. You want to ensure you send the right content type header value. You'll also want to make sure that the server can process whatever you specify for the content type header. Check over what the server can process through the accept header. You won't necessarily do this within WordPress's core files, although you may do so as a part of a REST API request. For example, a user from Stack Overflow had this exact issue when using pure PHP over CURL to make an API request. There are two places to look. First, specify the correct file types within the content type header. Second, this user had a typo while declaring an invalid header key using the WP remote post function. Because header misses an S, it would throw the HTTP 415 error. However, you'll also want to make sure that the client can accept the right file types too. You'll do this through another header, accept. For example, this makes sure both ends of the chain, the client and the server side, can accept and send the right file types and put a halt to the HTTP 415 error for good. WordPress errors are often straightforward to fix. We've done so a number of times on the Kinston blog, and the nature of the platform means you can be ready to rock and roll in a short while. However, the HTTP 415 error is different in that a fix is hard to come by if you're not a developer. While the 415 error is yours to fix, for other issues with your WordPress website, Kinsta is on call. We have our support team standing by to help you understand your site on rare occasions it fails to load. Looking for a quality local development solution? With DevKinsta and the single click, you can design, develop, and deploy new WordPress projects from your local machine. Plus, it's 100% free to use if you aren't a Kinsta customer. Download it today at kinsta.com/devkinsta. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.